It is an ambitious goal, build a village on the moon within the next 14 years, and the European Space Agency has its sights set on doing just that. We spoke to Director General of the ESA about what it would take to complete such a project and how a moon village could help astronauts make it to Mars.
It's clear for me that journey to Mars means not to fly to Mars in the next 5 or 10 years, but it is a long way, not only from the distance, but also from what we have to do on the technology side. To use the moon as a stepping stone, or as you said, as a pit stop, that's crucial, because we have to test, for instance, how to build structures on a planet, on a moon, instead of bringing all the stuff there. I mean, to the moon, all the missions to moon, Apollo, etc., they were bringing all the stuff to the site, and did not use the regolith, the moon soil, for something what they wanted to do over there. And in Moon Village, of course, we would use the moon material, for instance, to build a big observatory to look in deep into space from the moon, which is, especially from the far side of the moon, very interesting, because you don't have all the radiation from the Earth.
How many inhabitants do you envision? And when you talk about construction, I understand that 3D printers might become of good use.
Yes. So this is a good question. And the next question is usually, who is the mayor of that village? That's the next question. And I already got emails asking me whether they can apply already. So it's not a question of inhabitants. Yes, I'm sure there will be also permanently astronauts, cosmonauts, or taikonauts, meaning from different nations. But the main idea of the village is not to build some houses, a church, and a community hall, and something like that. But the basic idea is to put together the different capabilities, that maybe one country is bringing in a good robot producing 3D printing, another country is bringing in, for instance, a very nice rover, and a third country might bring in some astronauts. So this is the idea of the village, bringing together different competencies from different nations. And so it's not a question of number of inhabitants, but the number of spacefaring nations participating. And of course, as bigger this number is, the better it is. We have more than 50 spacefaring nations around the globe. And my dream is, as much as possible, we should include.
It also could save a lot of money. I mean, there was something about they could launch from Earth a lot lighter once stuff is up there, and it could save $10 billion a year by lightening the load from Earth to the Moon. Is that right?
Yeah, but you see, the money which is spent for space is always a discussion. And what I tell in Europe is, if you go with the metro in Paris and you buy a ticket for only one trip, this is more money for 1 year which you are using for human spaceflight in Europe. So it's not that expensive as it always said, because the number looks so big. But if you look to the world and all the inhabitants of the world, the citizens of the world, and if you take a fraction of the money available, then it doesn't count. And humans need this spirit of inspiration. I'm not so ready to calculate the benefit only in dollars or in euros, because I think inspiration is what we need for the future. And if we can drive inspiration, this is much higher value than any other. By the way, Apollo did that perfectly.
Fascinating stuff. It's really been great talking to you. I'm really bummed out about the fact that you won't have a mayor of your moon village. Not me. I was going to send you up when you misbehave and not let you come back to Earth.
Do you want to go, Jan? Do you want to go?
I would go. I mean, my birthday is the same birthday as John Glenn, the 18th of July. He was the first American orbiting the Earth, and the oldest one orbiting again. So I'm still younger than he was when he had his second trip to the orbit. So I'm ready to go.
Great idea.
Tomorrow. Tomorrow is fine. Friday is okay.
You got the weekend.
Let us know how it goes. Please keep in touch. Thank you so much, Jan Dietrich Wörner, the Director General of the European Space Agency. Appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you.
I guess you're about the only person around that doesn't have TV coverage of the scene.
That's all right, I don't mind a bit.
Okay, you've got the flag up now, and you can see the stars and stripes on the lunar.
Are you getting a TV picture of the moon?
picture now, Houston?
Neil, yes, we are getting a TV picture. You're in our field of view now.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap.